A special guest this morning, Whitney Gorsinger, joining us, who is the in-house wellness coordinator for the Garver Engineering Firm. Now, she's going to give us a few ways to take care of our mental health by building a resilient mindset. Good morning, Whitney. Hey, let me ask you, what is a resilient mindset? What does that mean?
Yeah, so it just means that we are going to be resilient and bounce back time and time and time again. So we're not going to let anything get us down. We're just going to, when we get knocked down, we're going to keep getting right back up.
I feel like I should play some song from the 90s, you know?
Yeah.
Okay. Anyway, all right. So what are some, do you have some tips on how to do this?
Absolutely, yeah. So the first thing I think we need to remember is just to keep things in perspective. So managing your expectations and allowing yourself to be flexible, even if it's you're very frustrated with the situation. It's just if you can control how you react to something, but you can't necessarily control anything else that happens to you, only yourself.
Yeah, if we kind of sometimes focus on those little bitty things, we're kind of missing the whole big picture, right?
Yeah, it can totally just like throw you off. And so when you do get thrown off, if you do get frustrated, mm-hmm. you can then also make sure to take care of yourself. So finding things that you enjoy doing, we've talked a lot about this throughout the past year. It'll just help boost your mood. It'll help bring your heart rate down, bring your stress levels down. So cooking, going for a walk outside, just hanging out with other people too, because you never know who might need a little extra love and care and support too. So you helping someone else will help you as well.
Now you are the wellness coordinator and you mentioned taking a walk. One thing that you always push for is like, you know, physical fitness and just getting the exercise and stuff, but it's not always just that. You mentioned cooking or actually getting closer to a friend, spending mm-hmm. that time. And those are obviously some healthy ways to do that, right?
Yeah. Absolutely. And then once you've created those relationships with people, I think the biggest takeaway in how to continue to be resilient is to ask for help when you need it. Again, whether that's with a friend or with a professional. So I'm a big advocate for therapy and counseling. Seeing a licensed mental health professional can help you find strategies to help you stay afloat and moving forward in those crisis moments. But then also, like you're taking care of a car, your body needs maintenance too. Your mental health needs maintenance as well. So continue to do that. Making sure that your mental health and well-being is your top priority.
Why do you think people are reluctant to get that professional help?
I think sometimes people think that, you know, you're considered crazy if you don't, if you go to therapy, but that's not true at all. I think everybody needs a therapist. Everybody needs a non-biased opinion and someone to talk to, because what goes on from here to here, it can be absolutely wild. So getting it out and talking to somebody is the best way to take care of
yourself. I like you said that you think everybody needs it because it's like we're all messed up somewhere or another. So we all need some help. So the people who actually get help, they're the ones actually probably taking the most advantage of things.
Exactly. So continue to be strong and positive and resilient in this 2021 because it's got to be better than 2020.
Couldn't be worse, could it? Whitney, thanks for joining us as always.